This podcast has been brought to you by Seekers Guidance, the global Islamic seminary. Help us spread the light of prophetic guidance to millions around the world by becoming a monthly supporter. Make a small donation at seekersguidance.org/donate. For as little as $10 a month, you can help people find life-changing guidance.
I want to accept everything as true in my faith, but sometimes I have doubt. What do I do about this doubt? This is a very important question, and this is something we see a lot of young people and many others suffering from. We acknowledge, we accept Islam, we believe everything in it, but then here and there we find a doubt and we have a struggle. Every doubt that you have, you must be able to address it. We cannot have doubts creep in our heart and then we don't address it. Doubts that linger on one after another become diseases and holes, or you can say a virus that will corrupt our faith. Walayadu billah. We as Muslims, when we accept our faith, when we accept Islam, we accept it 100%. We know our faith is not built on 99.9%, but 0.1, I have some doubt. It cannot be like that, brothers and sisters. Our faith and our deen, we cannot have any doubt therein. But the level of certitude in our hearts may waver. The level of how much conviction we have may change. We know that Islam is the truth, but we also know that good deeds raise your faith. Iman is increased by good deeds. Similarly, iman is decreased by sins and by doing awful things that are sinful. If we look at that, brothers and sisters, we see some companions, they used to be with the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and one of them one day, he said, you know, when I'm with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, everything is as if I can see it. I'm so close to hereafter. Everything is so real. Everything is so, with such certitude. But when I'm with my family, when I'm with my children, that certitude and everything doesn't last. I'm at a lower level than I was. And I think that I've become a hypocrite. And another companion said, by Allah, you're right. This is how I feel too. Maybe we should go to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and ask him. So they both felt that they had entered into a state of hypocrisy. And they went to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam basically told them that there is a time for that, that there is a time that, you know, if you stayed on this faith all the time, that you get to a point where you can even shake hands with the angels. But the nature of the human being is iman increases and decreases. That's natural. It's going to happen. What we can do by putting it practically in our lives is have a certain amount of good deeds that you do every single day and you do it consistently. If those doubts have to do with aqidah and faith, you must find someone who can address those questions of doubt for you. You must find a teacher. You must find a scholar. And in the past, when people used to have a concerning question, when people had something very, very important, they even used to travel for months on end until they got the question to that, the answer to that question of theirs, because they were concerned about their faith. And our faith, brothers and sisters, is the most important thing that we need to value. Our faith is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our faith is in every single moment simultaneously preserved and created in our heart by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is al-mu'min, and he is the one, this is one of his blessed names, the source of belief. Allah ta'ala grants that to whom he wills. But in order for us to preserve that, there's an element of responsibility on our part, but then the real doer and giver and bestower of that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one, make dua to Allah to always keep your faith strong. And that's why one of the du'as that we find, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi'imanan da'ima. Oh Allah, we ask you for iman da'ima, consistent, perpetual, without end. Wa yaqeenan sadiqa, in a certitude that is true, strong certitude. And so forth. So, number one, make du'a to Allah always at every prayer, at every moment, to preserve our faith, number one. Number two, increase in good deeds. If that doubt has to do with something in aqidah, seek it out. Because the bottom line is our Islamic theology and our faith is truth and must be truth. So don't fear, oh, I'm going to go into something, what if it leaves more doubts? No, it will not. Inshallah, Allah Ta'ala will protect you. True faith is reality of existence, right? So don't be afraid of that. But you, because one teacher may not be able to answer your question, do not think that that's the faith, that that is Islam. It may be the limited ability of that teacher who you have access to, but there are other teachers, right? You can come across a teacher that has a relationship with Allah where before you even get there, he can answer your question without you even asking your question, right? There's a story of our teacher, Sheikh Hamza Yusuf, in which when he first met Sheikh Murabit al-Hajj, he had a dream of Sheikh Murabit the night before or sometime before, in which he saw him. And when he entered into his tent, he was looking for a righteous guide and a Sheikh, someone he can study with. When he entered in, without saying anything, the Sheikh turned to him and he said, is this like your dream that you saw? Without even him telling the dream, right? So there are people like that. Don't ever underestimate the power of Allah and the subtleties of Allah Ta'ala's guidance. So ask, because that's the cure to ignorance. Ask and look for it. Search it. I'm amazed that Muslims who have doubts, but then don't do anything about that doubt, they just let it sit there. I once had a man came to me. He said, I've had a doubt and a thought in my head for 30 years. I said, SubhanAllah, 30 years. And he's like, I've never really been able to ask anybody, but I want to ask you. So here I am, like, great, after 30 years, Ya Rabb, I hope I have success in how I answer this question. But then the reality is that the guide is Allah. We can only do so much, you know. Those who are asked can only do so much. The real guide is Allah. So ask those things that put doubt in your aqidah, in your faith. If it has to do with other than aqidah, right? So if it has to do with just your level of yaqeen and certitude, that's going to waver. It's going to be at times very high where you feel you have no doubt whatsoever. And at times you're going to have these creeping doubts and about the hereafter, about is this all real? A lot of that you have to understand is not necessarily doubts that you have. These are waswasa from shaytan, right? These are waswasa from shaytan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in one ayah about the tricks of shaytan, that he says, I'll come from in front of them, from behind them, from their right and their left. And ulama mentioned, some of the ulama commented on this, said that you'll come from the front and the back, meaning that he will put doubts about the hereafter in front of you. He will put doubts about the grave, doubts about the day of judgment and the hereafter. That's shaytan. But if Allah protects us from those waswasa, he didn't say shaytan that he'll come from the top and the bottom. You know, revelation is downward, guidance is from downward, that when we connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything all around us will become irrelevant. Allah ta'ala will be your guide, he will be your protector, he will be the one who assists you, and he is the one that's going to strengthen your faith. One companion, he converted to Islam, but because he really just felt sorry for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he called him all the time, and he would always tell him about Islam, and he felt he's a good man. And, you know, not all non-Muslims in Mecca were antagonistic. They were just enemies of Islam, or they wanted to hurt the Prophet ﷺ. No, some were just regular people who heard the da'wah, like this companion, but he felt so bad for the Prophet ﷺ that he didn't want to keep saying no to him. So he just said, okay, I'll accept your faith. And he said shahada. And he said it was one day that he was praying and he heard an ayah of the Quran. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِذُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. This is an ayah often repeated in Salat al-Jum'ah. For your homework, you can look this up and look at the different translations and tafsir, because we don't have time for that to go into, unless it's a massive request, and inshallah in the future we can do that. But this ayah, when he heard it, that it was so inclusive of every good and so clarifying of every wrong, that he said in its eloquence and its beauty and its content, there's no way any human could have said that. And he said at that moment, true faith entered his heart. True faith entered his heart. So yes, some doubts are from shaytan. some doubts where you really have a question, like, I don't know about that. You know, I really struggle. I'm not sure. Then ask, you know, and find the right scholar to be able to answer that question. Seek it yourself. You know, and I've spoken to people that really struggle with some things that are realities, and they understand it. They understand what Islam is saying, but they just can't get their heart to accept it, even though they know the religion is true. And that's something that we ask Allah Ta'ala, Ya Allah, the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, none of you believe until his caprice is in line with that which I brought, until his hawa, all that he desires, and he aligns himself up with what he believes, how what he adheres to, everything is in line with what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam brought. And that's a gift from Allah. And so we do those steps, inshallah, and we ask Allah Ta'ala to help us in it, Ya Rabbil Alameen.
Thank you for listening. This podcast was brought to you by Seekers Guidance, the global Islamic seminary. Visit seekersguidance.org to access reliable Islamic knowledge taught by qualified teachers. We offer a wide range of courses, podcasts, articles, and a world-class answer service. Support us in spreading free, reliable Islamic knowledge to millions around the world by becoming a monthly supporter. Visit seekersguidance.org/donate. And make a small monthly commitment today. Our beloved Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, said, whoever guides someone to goodness will have a similar reward. So don't forget to share this podcast and spread prophetic guidance.